Hello everybody, and welcome back to the Kingdom Hearts 2 playthrough! It's time for us to visit another new world, and it's kind of, sort of, the last new world that we're going to. The actual last world that we're... new world that we are technically going to is sort of inside of another world. And obviously there is the kind of issue of Atlantica just sitting off there. The game has expected us to have gone there before, but that's not happening. So we are instead going to the wonderful Pride Lands, based on the incredibly stupidly popular The Lion King. Like, I think for the longest time, it's been generally seen as like one of the best Disney films for, like, up until Frozen. Obviously, whether you agree with that statement or not is a different matter. For various reasons, it's just like whether you classify Lion King as, like, one of the best Disney films ever, or whether you think that Disney has managed to ever quite match up to that since. Whether, kind of, the first best film was, like, Princess and the Frog, Tangled, or Wreck-It Ralph, or... Frozen, leave that at the door, but it was kind of seen as one of the last great films of the Disney Renaissance. And it actually came out the year that I was born, which is just awesome, so 1994, which makes me very happy. So I'm just a little bit older than The Lion King, which is so cool. And, I mean, The Lion King's kind of got a lot going on in it, because obviously there is the whole copyright issue, because it's got a lot of links to Kimba the White Lion. There is all that issue. But it is also basically influenced by the tales of Joseph and Moses in the Bible, and is also basically Hamlet by Shakespeare. Which is just awesome. Like, I mean, it's not exactly the same, because there is no weird sort of sexual tension between Simba and his mother, like there is between Hamlet and Gertrude. And also, Simba doesn't find out about what Scar did until right at the end of the film, whereas Hamlet finds out pretty much at the start of the film that, I think it's Claudius, killed his father, and then spends the rest of the play trying to decide whether he needs to or wants to go through with getting revenge, and then tragedy ensues. But either way, thankfully we don't have many more of the Gummy Ship segments to go. There's like 3 left-ish, which makes me very grateful, because, kind of, as you can probably tell, I've run out of things to say about these things. They're literally just the same thing again and again and again. It's much more involved than it was in the original game. Like, my god, it was hell to suffer through the tedium of it in the first game, so this is much, much, much better. It's just that once you've said stuff about it, you've said everything, including having said that you've already said everything about these damn things. Also, as much as I like kind of these types of shooter-y type things, I mean, it's sort of Space Harrier-y and stuff, I don't like like proper shmups. Like Japanese shmups with all the bullet hell chaos going on. That doesn't appeal to me, and it's just like, I don't even know what I'm supposed to be looking at, let alone be able to play this properly. But either way, we are entering the Pride Lands, and we get a really, really interesting thing going on here, because in all of the other worlds, the little prologue thing that happens before we kind of properly get into the world has been, like, literally just before what's going to happen in the game. the Pride Lands does away with that, and actually does a sort of callback. Well, it's basically a recreation of the stampede scene from the Lion King film. Unfortunately, it doesn't quite have the same emotive resonance, because there is, if I recall correctly, absolutely no music going on during this, and or at least it's really weird. It's like, just, it's not very terrifying. So yeah, you see what I mean by just choice of music and choice of how you present something just makes it completely lose all resonance that it could have had, which just really sucks, because that's such an important and hugely well done scene in the film. It's heartbreaking. And then they just did it here and it's just kind of... eh. I mean, I guess in many ways I just want to hear Jeremy Irons kind of with Scar's claws in Mufasa's just going, "Long live the king," before letting him go. Just such a great moment.
Hey, check us out. This place is kind of creepy though. Mm-hmm. Ooh. Heartless?
Oh, I don't know, Sora. I get the feeling they might live here.
Don't mind us. Just passing through. We won't be any trouble.
Yeah, that's right.
Don't be silly. We love you to stick around for lunch.
We didn't bring anything to eat.
That's not gonna be a problem.
Gosh, Sora. I think we're the lunch.
Whoa!
Going somewhere? Man, that Scar's got the worst timing.
Just let him roar.
We better go see what he wants. Sounds like he's grumpy enough already.
Fine.
I don't know what that was about, but I'm glad it's over. Everything's harder on four legs.
Why don't you stop practicing?
I found a trick to it. Here, let me show you.
Once again, Goofy, source of sage advice everywhere. But yes, we get to play as Lion Sora! Which is quite funny, because initially in the designs for Sora, Sora is going to be a lion man child thing. So it's quite cool that they got to do this. And also, I think, if I recall correctly, the Pride Lands was going to appear in the original Kingdom Hearts, but it was removed due to time constraints, because of obviously the four-legged movement and fighting style was, I mean, at the time it was too much to handle, so it's cool that they got to come back to it here. So, theme-wise, the main field theme in Pride Lands is Adventures in the Savannah, and the battle theme is Savannah Pride. So it's all linked into the Savannah and the where we are. Now, we're going to have kind of a lot of stuff happening during this world. I mean, it's like a very long one, if I recall correctly, largely because this is the last kind of new world before we get into what's going to lead us into the second half of the game, basically.
What do we do?
Stay back!
So we begin our first fight, and these guys are kind of evil. I mean, there are some enemies which hit damn hard in this place. It's insane. But as long as you kind of make sure to try and get those reaction commands, you should get through it all right. So it's probably begin my very, very long list of voice actors in this world. There's a huge amount. So I'll get back to some of the other people in a minute, but the main ones that I want to deal with now are the hyenas, Shenzi, Banzai, and Ed. So Ed is voiced, so the one who kind of just laughs a lot, that's Jim Cummings, we've already discussed. Shenzi, who's the female one, is voiced by Tress McNeil, although in the original film she was voiced by Whoopi Goldberg, which is amazing.
Thank you. You really saved
me. And then the other one, Banzai, is voiced by Cheech Marin. Who
is that what they're called?
Pretty much everyone would probably recognize as also being Tito in Oliver and Company, the Chihuahua. Which is just awesome.
Hey, do you know if a guy named Riku is there? Or some bad guys in black hoods? Or maybe this really big bully named Pete? Oh well, we might as well go take a look anyway.
Wait, the Pride Lands are dangerous. Scar and the hyenas have made things unbearable for everyone. There's no food left. They've driven off the prey. We're about to starve.
We can handle a little danger. You just saw us beat those Heartless, didn't you?
I guess you're right. You could be just what the kingdom needs. Maybe you can help us.
You mean take on this Scar guy and all those hyenas?
Scar?
He took over when our last king, Mufasa, died.
So you're saying this guy's your king? You want us to take down your king? Wait just a minute. We can't just go around knocking kings off their thrones. Then again, if they see that I'm stronger than their king, maybe they'll ask me to be their next king.
Sora?
I'd have to refuse, of course. Still, I'd like to see the Pride Lands, so you guys don't mind lending them a paw, do you?
There it goes again.
She's gonna go on ahead and tell the other lionesses. We're supposed to meet her at a place called Pride Rock.
Yeah, it's not gonna be very difficult to find it, I suspect. And as we kind of begin to move along, I'll just go into a few more of Cheech Marin's roles, because he's been in a heck of a lot. So, Tito in Oliver and Company. He's also Felix Gum in the Spy Kids series, so Uncle Felix, which is just awesome. And he's also Ramon in Cars, as well as a few other things, but just the Oliver and Company one and the Spy Kids ones just make me very happy. And also there we had Nala, who is voiced here by Vanessa Marshall. In the original film, she was voiced by, I believe it's Moira Kelly, but they couldn't get her back, so they went with Vanessa Marshall, who has been in a variety of things, as is pretty much everybody. That seems to be the way I introduce people. But in video game stuff, she's the car computer in 007 Nightfire. She is Nani in the Lilo and Stitch game. She is Dr. Naomi in No More Heroes. In Shrek 2, the game, she's the voice of the Wicked Witch, Cinderella, and Grandma. She's Sparx's mother in The Legend of Spyro, A New Beginning. She's also Miss Bloody Rachel in Beautiful Joe 2, as well as Sprocket Rachel and Sukumo in Beautiful Joe Red Hot Rumble. And yeah, I don't think there's anything that she's particularly well known for. I mean, Drew Saturday in Ben 10 Omniverse, Mary Jane Watson in The Spectacular Spider-Man. She's voiced Poison Ivy in Batman the Brave and the Bold, along with quite a few other things. Dinah Lance / Black Canary in Young Justice, and so on and so forth. But obviously here we see that the Pride Lands are kind of desolate, because obviously we're in the middle of Scar's reign, so the lands are dying. But in this really huge area, basically, just lots of heartless to kill. I mean, it's slightly frustrating because I think the Heartless are meant to kind of just constantly respawn in this area, so you're kind of meant to be able to run around the entire thing and just constantly get Heartless to kill. But I've never quite been able to get that to work, which is really frustrating. Like, just so stupidly frustrating. And this is going back to voice actors because it's all I seem to be caring about in Kingdom Hearts 2 this time. is that when they did the recreation of the Stampede scene, they used archive footage, well, audio footage, of Jonathan Taylor Thomas voicing young Simba. So that is exactly as it is in the movie, which, I mean, it's cool that they did reuse it, because when they did the Morning Report and inserted it into the Blu-ray of The Lion King. Oh my god. They didn't even try to get a voice for Simba that sounded remarkably similar to the original voice. They just went with, let's just get some random child to do the singing. It was just like, it was just no. Just all sorts of no. That song in the Broadway West End production is hilarious, but they just not that simple voice.
Might be able to help us force Scar and the hyenas out of the Pride Lands, but he says it won't work. You see, whoever saves the Pride Lands will be our next king, and he has to have the right qualities. Meaning?
Well, I think she means you're not cut out for the job, Sora.
I'm sorry you came all this way.
Hey, no, it's okay.
You better go before Scar finds out you're here. I'm really sorry.
So, yeah, this is all kind of just quite cool. Also, I'm very much wanting to go, Sora, do you see that dark area off in the distance in shadows? You must never go there. Because, I mean, basically, that's a kind of running joke. So, like, in where I come from, it's like, what's that over there? It's St. Anne's. Or the meadows. You must never go there. Because obviously in every city there's the rough areas. And that's where our rough areas are. Also, just in terms of distance, that's always a quite funny one. Also, you can do a really cool thing where you can jump off the top of Pride Rock and it's just like, whee! And then you don't really splat, but it is just quite cool to just take a running leap off of Pride Rock and just land. But yeah, I mean, the Pride Lands is actually really big. I mean, you get through it quite quickly because you have the ability to kind of dash about, and that lets you through things so quickly. It lets you cover vast distances, but it does also mean that the Pride Lands do end up being quite large and empty, which is a little bit depressing.
Hey, a snack!
Snack? Nah! Mm-mm. We got us a three-course meal!
Look at that! Here comes Scar, the king!
And Pete!
Absolutely no idea why his body changed for this world and not the others, but I guess Maleficent decided you need to go undercover for this one. But... ah, Lion Pete, it's so funny.
My back!
What are you doing here?
Oh, the cute little kitty's worried about me. If I were you, I'd be more worried about my friends. We're surrounded!
Go on, ladies. You've got some hunting to do.
The herds have moved on, Scar. We can't hunt in a land with no prey.
No prey? Then what do you call this?
We're not prey.
Oh, nice and fresh, too.
Well, they're all yours, Scar.
Oh!
Run! Follow me!
So, there we had Scar, who here, I don't know why, but either way, here he's voiced by James Horan, who is most well known as Richard Lacroix in Starship Troopers Chronicles, Wheeljack in Transformers Prime, and Skullface, or he will be well known as Skullface in Metal Gear Solid 5. I don't really think he's done that much. Well, he's actually also going to be the voice of the Arkham Knight in Batman Arkham Knight, so that's going to be a thing. But the reason why I'm surprised that they've got James Horan in to do the voice of Scar here, because it's not a particularly great rendition of the voice that Jeremy Irons has. But the reason that I'm confused is because during Be Prepared, which is Scar's big song, and I mean, it's a great villain song, I love Be Prepared, kind of, I think during recording, Jeremy Irons' voice kind of just blew out, so he couldn't finish the song, so they had to get someone else in to do it, and the person that they got in to do it was, I believe, Jim Cummings. So it's just like, hello? Jim Cummings can do an absolutely phenomenal Scar voice. You have got Jim Cummings working on this game.
Hey, why the long
come
day,
on.
Simba?
You surely, you know, yeah. It makes sense to let him do it, considering he's also...
the past, right?
Actually voices him in Lion King 2 Simba's Pride as well. So it's just like, guys, make use of your voice actors, especially when they can do a phenomenal Scar voice.
Would you look how he's grown, Pumbaa? Why, when I rescued the little guy, he was only this big.
The lack of the words SEX, or as it really should be, SFX, in that stuff is disappointing. I wanted to see that level of detail. Come on, guys.
What's wrong?
We're never gonna make it.
I guess Rafiki was right.
What?
Never mind, it's not important. Here, I'll show you how. You can do it.
And just like magic, we learned a new ability. It's great. We've learned the ability to dash, which means we can get places very quickly. It also means that we kind of have this weird sort of slide thing now that goes on, so you try to turn and you just sort of slide around. It can be quite cool just blitzing around the area, although rather annoyingly, you know, I very much want to get all my treasure chests, and blitzing through the area doesn't help when you're trying to do that, because you miss things. So I have to go slowly. But I mean, these areas are huge! Although I think... I don't know whether I'm right on this, but I think they may use this valley, or at least sort of reuse elements of the assets for this valley later on in the game. I'm specifically thinking of another kind of battle area that takes place in a sort of valley canyon type thing. It would not surprise me in the slightest if they did. I'll have to have a peek when we get there. Just double check that I'm not losing my mind in the similarities there, although I guess two valleys in the same game, you sort of do tend to make those sort of connections even if they're not actually there. Oh, just the slide. I just love the slide. It's just so awesome. Also, as we get closer and closer and closer to where we need to be, there's going to be a lot of cutscenes. A lot of cutscenes.
When Simba's father, King Mufasa, died, we were told that Simba died alongside him.
Who told you that?
Scar.
It is time.
It must be Simba! Sora, hurry!
Wait up!